Today I'm going to show you how I go about recovering data from a dead computer. Now by dead I mean that when I press the power button, nothing happens. You see nothing on the screen and no lights come on. Now a lot of people, when they have a computer that doesn't start up and nothing comes on the screen when they press the button, they assume that they've lost everything on the hard drive. But that's not actually the case. If the hard drive has failed, you can indeed lose everything, but if the hard drive had failed, we would actually see different symptoms. If the hard drive of a computer has failed, you typically will see something on the screen when you press a power button, typically a power on self test or maybe a logo. In this case, this is a Dell computer, so a Dell logo would probably appear on the screen. So the fact that nothing happens when we press the button usually indicates that the problem lies somewhere else. In other words, it might be a motherboard problem, or a processor or a RAM problem or something like that. So we're going to assume the hard drive is probably okay, and so that means we can actually remove the hard drive from this machine, plug it into another machine, and try to retrieve the data. So let's get started. Now usually on a laptop it's not too hard to find the hard drive. There are exceptions to that, but usually one of these panels on the back is the hard drive, or in this case the hard drive is actually right here on the side. If I just pull this out, I believe the hard drive will be in there. Occasionally you get a laptop that you need to remove the keyboard on the top of it in order to get to the drive, but that's become pretty rare on the modern laptops. So here I'm going to go ahead and remove the hard drive. Now this hard drive here is actually in a tray which has a special connector on the back. This is not a standard connector. But the hard drive itself is standard, and that would usually be the case with any hard drive you have. So I'm going to go ahead and take the hard drive out of the tray, and that will expose the industry standard connector on the back, and that way I can hook it to another computer. Now here I have the hard drive out, and it has a standard IDE connector, the older type. The newer drives have something called serial ATA or SATA, which looks somewhat different than this. But this old one is a standard connector too. Some of the newer computers may not have a place to attach a drive like this, but I have a computer here in my workroom that I can attach it to. The problem is, with the older type connector, desktop hard drives and laptop hard drives, the connector is different. And so here I am trying to connect a laptop hard drive to a desktop machine to do data recovery, and I'll need to use an adapter in order to connect it. Now with the newer SATA connections, both laptop hard drives and desktop hard drives have the same type of connector. They're exactly the same with SATA, and so for that reason you don't need an adapter of any kind when you hook one up to do data recovery like this. Okay, here you can see that I have my workbench computer opened up, and I've disconnected the CD-ROM drive, and I have the IDE connector and the power connector here to attach the laptop hard drive. Now as I said, that connector isn't compatible with the laptop drive. The connection on a laptop drive is somewhat different, and so that's where this adapter comes in, so I can attach a laptop drive to a desktop computer. Now an adapter like this is readily available. If you do a search on Google or Amazon, you should be able to find one of these for relatively cheap. I don't know how long they'll be around though, because SATA connections are really commonplace today. And so the older these computers get, the less demand that there'll be for adapters like this. So if you're going to do work on old computers, might be best you get one of these before they disappear. Okay, there, I have the drive hooked up to the desktop computer, so I'm going to go ahead and fire it up and see if I can get the data off. Okay, here I have the computer running, and I'm looking at the My Computer window. There are three drives listed here, drives C, D, and E. Now I happen to know, based on the size that's reported down here when I click on these, that this one, this drive D, is the one that I actually just connected. These two here, E and C, are drives that were already attached to my computer. So this is the one I need, and the fact that it's showing up here is a real good sign when it comes to getting data off, so I'll double click on it. And I see in my documents folder right in the root of the drive, that must apparently means that they were using Windows 98. This was an older computer. If we were using Windows XP, we wouldn't find the My Documents folder in the root folder. I'm just going to go in there and see what I can find. Yeah, it looks like there's a lot of stuff in there. So this looks good. It looks like we're going to be able to retrieve some data off of here. I'll have to rummage around a little bit and figure out where all the information is that they need, and then I'll just copy it over to a USB flash drive or something to give it to the customer to put on their new computer. Thanks for watching today's video episode of Bernardo's Tech Blog. Feel free to stop by our blog site at www.bernardotech.org. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.